I said in your intro that you are an avatar. You are at least an ascending master. You're definitely a master.
You called me an ascended fatster.
I did not.
Okay, you called my husband.
Yes, exactly. It was Jeremy. You started it though.
I totally did. I'm not an avatar. I'm not. But thank you. I am. I just am somebody. I think I'm old enough now. You know, I'm 50 years old, which I like to say. I like to just claim that.
Yeah.
I'm old enough now to not really give a shit, Trisha Carr, about making a whole lot of money, living in a McMansion, riding up in my Lamborghini. I'm about making a difference with my life for however long I'm going to be here. I'm about equipping people with whatever it is I can give them, show them, demonstrate for them that will help them to live a better life and be more at peace within themselves. Mm-hmm. And so everything that I do, and we're talking about light work today. That's what that is. Mm-hmm. I was trying to think, like, how am I going to break down what a light worker is? First of all, let me say, it's getting real buzzy out there with that term, you know, oh, light worker.
I know.
Too many people are saying it now, so there's a saturation level, but that's okay. What a light worker is, simply a person. We're all made of light. When you look at us, right, as our most fundamental, as an energy, we're just light. We're a pattern of light that's moving around in this reality. So we're all light. But a light worker is somebody that's doing something with that, mm-hmm. who's using their light intentionally and pointing it in a direction in order to shift themselves, shift their community, shift this planet, or to more closely align to the divine. That's what a light worker is.
Well, what I find interesting when I of course, I was tongue in cheek saying that you're an avatar, and you know, Jesus would say, of course you're an avatar. You're all avatars, because you know what I mean? But you did almost directly quote a scripture, and then it keeps reflecting in the next thing that you're going to say, seek ye first the kingdom of heaven and all these things will be added unto you as well. And the kingdom of heaven is within. As you said, we help people in the intuitive intensive to find their well of their truth and their inner source energy, their inner God essence. And that is the activity, I guess, of a light worker, is to be expressing and holding space for others, expressing it for themselves and holding space for others to be able to connect with that as well.
Yes, in whatever way that shows up for them. And getting people to understand that they are powerful enough to use their lives in a way that changes their life and somebody else's life. And also that that's what they came here to do. Mm-hmm. Because I think a lot of people don't feel connected to the reality that they can make a change, or that they're powerful enough, or that they have the true grit, if you will, to make that kind of change. And that's where we start. We start by teaching people and emboldening people with the reality that they're not just Crystal Ann Compton living in a 3D reality on this crazy planet. They are, in fact, a divine being who very playfully opted in to this reality in order to navigate and have an adventure, and also to help this dimension as it ascends. Because I do believe we're changing, we're shifting, consciousness is shifting and changing. And that's why we came. We wanted to be here. And once we align with how powerful we are and what we really bring to the table, that's when we start talking about things like accelerated expansion, accelerated ascension, and really helping the collective get pulled into this higher reality that I think we're moving toward.
I love that you said, you took us back to the pre-birth experience, and you said we playfully opted in. And I see that a lot. I see that when I work with animals or humans, when animals are on the other side, and it's like the second they pop out, they're like, oh, it's all just been a joke. You know, I mean, like, I'm so sorry that my leaving is making you sad, but I'm cool.
It's true.
Realize you were just playing a game the whole time.
Well, and I mean, I think that's the way the soul looks at it. Mm. I mean, we're having an adventure, and we're not just in this reality, BT dubs. We're in a lot of different realities simultaneously,
yes,
having all kinds of experiences. But Crystal Ann Compton chose this one for such a time as this. And so I'm going to make the most of it. Mm. And I have a lot of my own gifts. I have a lot of my own talents, and I'm going to use them, and I'm going to shine that light. Why am I going to hide it under a bushel? Mm. You know, and there again, I think my age speaks to that. Like, I had to live a lot of life. I had to go through a lot of different things in order to feel like I just don't care anymore. Like, this is the way I want to live my life. But one thing I would really like to encourage other people to do is not wait as long as I did to kind of get my stuff together or to get on the path. I would really have loved to have that conversation with the younger Crystal M. Milligan and tell her how powerful she is and tell her what she can accomplish and really connect her with the reality of that. And so that's some of the stuff that I love to do. And I know that you love to do as well.
Absolutely. Well, that brings me the most joy. It's all about, you know, the theme. I think that pretty much everyone, I think everyone can relate to this, is inspiration, wanting to experience inspiration. And then that is a natural overflowing to inspire others or to hold that place of inspiration for others, connect with them as they are feeling inspiration. I think that's that to me is kind of how I would sum up what light work is for me. Do you connect with that?
Yes, absolutely. And I think it happens very naturally. Mm-hmm. Once you fill up with that, then it spills over and it affects everything. That's how it's supposed to work. Mm-hmm. I do believe it has to start with self and how we love ourselves and giving ourselves permission to be exactly who it is that we came here to be and giving ourselves the latitude to express ourselves in the way that we came here to express ourselves. I think people, again, so locked up, you know, so locked up in systems, locked up in patterns, locked up in relationships and in jobs, and they don't feel free enough to express themselves in this way. So it starts with loving yourself enough and knowing who it is that you are. And from there, we start getting into the work part of being the light.